So we've been talking about the battle for the mind. In my years of leadership and experience, traveling the world, training, teaching people, this is an area that I believe is maybe the most profound and most important thing that we can deal with. I am a big believer in the power of God and the grace of God and what God can do in a person's life. I spend my years sharing that with people. But I also know that God is not going to do for you what you can do for yourself. And one of the things that I've learned is that we focus so much on the spiritual health and the spiritual awareness of a person. And we oftentimes don't spend time telling a person, you've got to change your thinking. Your beliefs are screwed up. What you believe to be true about certain things is going to hold you back and keep you from experiencing the full measure of what God has for you. I've met lots of people that have tremendous potential, yet they have a poverty mindset. I've met a whole lot of people that frankly have the capacity to build and to grow multi-million dollar enterprises in the business sector, but they have a religious mindset and they won't go do that because they believe it's unspiritual. I've met people that have been raised in poor or underprivileged environments, and we live in a land of opportunity, and we certainly live with the grace and the word of God in our life. So whatever God has said about us is true, and whatever he said we can do no matter where we come from. But yet it is our mindset, our thinking, and our beliefs about what we can do that actually drives and governs our life. I want to say to you today, as we wrap this series up, explore honestly from a sincere heart and a place of transparency. Explore the beliefs that you hold. If you're not seeing in your life today the results that you believe are for you, if you're not seeing in your life today the results that you believe that God has spoken to you, if you're not seeing in your life today the kinds of opportunities and outcomes and presentations of the glory of God showing up in your life and big things happening that you believe might be possible, then I would say to you, the only thing keeping you from it is you. There's something in there that's not allowing you the freedom and the mobility to move with it, to go with it, to take action. See, where there is doubt, there is hesitation. And where there is hesitation, a person will not take action and move toward that which God's presented to them. So if you find yourself dreaming but not moving, I suggest to you that right now you're not winning the battle. But I believe in you. I know you can. And I want to challenge you today, go after limiting beliefs with a tenacity. Dive into some of the resources that are offered at brianholmes.com. We have a series called The Battle for the Mind that goes in depth in this subject. I want you to take seriously the opportunity you're given right now to take your life to the next level. We've said it before, I'm going to say it again. When you change your mind, you do change your world. My name is Brian Holmes. Thanks for joining us on this segment. And I look forward to seeing you again very, very soon.